back to our agenda. We are at Good and Welfare.
Thank you, Madam Clerk. I'm going to start sort of what we've been doing tonight, because I think we have another meeting in a month. So I think we would be well served to perhaps get some clarification moving forward, because frankly, this is no way for our government to operate. I mean, the council, the mayor, we should be able to speak on public issues without fear of an Open Meeting Act violation, when really, there isn't one to be made. I mean, Councilwoman Sierra, and I certainly understand the position that we as a council, the things that Councilman Cronin said, and certainly the council president is doing a good job in trying to protect the members of this council and operating under an abundance of caution. But I don't think the legislative intent is to hold us back from talking about public issues and keeping the mayor from talking about issues of public concern. And I don't think that that's actually what the ruling that served as a warning said. I just think that it would be, I mean, look, a lot of times when, and I understand what Councilman Cronin said about former Councilman Fagnan, it was unclear what he wanted to talk about, and I get that. Okay, but a lot of times, the intent of the communications from the public are pretty clear. Tonight, they were very clear by these council people, Councilwoman Sierra and Ward. And I think the fact that they have to sit here and cautiously monitor their words for fear of reprisal, when they were pretty clear about what they wanted to talk about and the issues of public concern. But I don't think it serves anybody well. I mean, the fact that this is what we're here for. I mean, we're not talking about a specific individual. We're not talking about not giving notice to any one person about their ability to come and speak about that issue. Can you get some clarification before the next meeting?
We'll try to get some clarification. You know, we have to do a change general with different staff, and so we have to adjust to how they want to interpret. Of course, if it's something that we feel strongly about, we could always, even though we get their decision, we could always appeal. We didn't appeal the last one because you and I talked, and I thought that decision was within the ballpark of reasonability. But if we did have someone file a complaint, for instance, one of the four issues that Councilwoman Sierra talked about, and the AG didn't agree with us, that may be one that we would think about. So I think it's prudent that the Council President and I talk, it's prudent to be on the safe side, but when there does come something that we feel as though the notice is adequate and one of the Council members wants to talk about it,
I mean, the alternative is that you're going to have council people writing out their agendas like it's War and Peace to make sure that it's covered, and nobody wants that either.
No.
There's got to be a middle ground here.
And I think that's something that we should try to set and talk about it and come up with some kind of policy. But I don't have any problem with the four topics that I'm just looking at now. I think we could have talked more on the purchase. On number three, we could have talked more. Number one, I had somewhat of an issue with because it is private and there are other things going on with it. But the other three, I don't think I can refrain from talking about what you want to talk about.
I guess my only argument there would be, not so much an argument, but my only thought about that would be, we're talking about an indoor gun range as a council that we were approved in the past, so that's been a publicly spoken about issue. So we're basically talking about an ongoing issue of public concern that this council has considered. So that, it's not like there's a whole lot of indoor gun ranges being proposed in the city.
Right, but keep in mind it's not what we did in the past. And I agree with you in terms of how they interpret the Open Meetings. It's the notice that you give for that particular meeting and agenda. It's not, you can't assume that the public knows what you did last year or 3 months ago or 2 weeks ago. So it's notice that goes on the agenda. And I agree with you. I don't agree with that. I probably voted for the Open Meetings, so I didn't think that they would take it to the extreme that they're taking it. It does stifle the debate. But perhaps we can come up with something. I'll talk with the council president. We could talk a case-by-case basis, right? So that will be come up because we'll have to do some type of massaging and common sense.
Right, like I said, also taking into consideration every AG is different.